Hi, my name's Henry Lukas. I'm the Education Director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History, located on the campus of Regis College in Weston. And we're here today in our philatelic library, as a part of the museum, to give you our May show called Going Postal. And this is a show where we try to show you stamps that relate to historic events, famous people, and stories in the news, and all other things to kind of show you that stamps really do can give you a lot of information just on that little piece of paper. Since this is May, we like to recognize two important events in stamp history. One is May is the anniversary of the very first postage stamp issued in May of 1840. You can see a stamp image behind me. That's Queen Victoria on a stamp called the One Penny Black. And many people still don't know that postage stamps are an invention. And until 1840, we didn't have stamps. People sent letters, and the person getting the letter, 9 times out of 10, had to pay. It wasn't a very good system over in England or anywhere else, so the British decided, let's make the person sending the letter pay. And the way we show that, give them a little piece of paper, Queen Victoria, who had just become queen, on the front of the stamp, glue on the back, stick it on the envelope, and send it anywhere in England. So that really was the birth of the postage stamp. Came out on May 1st, but the first stamps weren't really officially used until May 6th. So that's our first May anniversary. The second one is airmail. Airmail now has been around for almost 101 years. It came out in May of 1918, and by that time planes were safe enough for delivering the mail, and the first mail run went from Washington, D.C. to Philadelphia, up to New York, and then eventually to Boston. So airmail really, as I say, took off and helped get the mail faster. So those are our two big May anniversaries that we have here in philatelic world. Also, this is May, so we like to feature some big event going on. And what's a bigger event in May than the Kentucky Derby down there at Churchill Downs in Kentucky? And there's several stamps related to the Kentucky Derby. One of them is a Canadian stamp for the famous racing horse Northern Dancer. It was a Canadian-bred thoroughbred, won the 1964 Kentucky Derby and the Preakness Stakes, and then became one of the most successful sires of the 20th century. So successful and well-known, he's considered a Canadian icon and inducted into the Canadian Sports Hall of Fame. A little closer to home, everybody knows about Secretariat, who was born on March 30th, 1970, and lived until 1989. An American thoroughbred, racehorse, 73, became the first Triple Crown winner in 25 years. And his record-breaking victory in the Belmont Stakes, which he won by 31 lengths, widely regarded as one of the greatest races of all time. So you can see a little Secretariat State stamp up there. That stamp, by the way, was part of a century series from the 1970s. People could actually vote on what topics they wanted on a stamp. They finally narrowed it down to 15 topics, and Secretariat was one chosen. Didn't quite make the top list. The top one was the smiley face of 1970s, and Sesame Street and the Pittsburgh Steelers got a few more votes, but Secretariat did get on the stamp. Talking about anniversaries just a few minutes, minutes ago, there are some other anniversaries taking place in 2019. One of them being celebrated by the post office is Sesame Street. Sesame Street has been around now for 50 years, and although it was on that century series I mentioned, a new set of stamps coming out from the post office going to feature a lot of your favorite Sesame Street characters, such as Count Dracula, and of course Bert and Ernie, and Elmo. So there you can see the whole collection of Sesame Street characters that you can get at your local post office. Another anniversary, 500th anniversary of the birth of of Leo da Vinci, and a lot of countries are issuing stamps to honor him. The one I'm showing you here is from England. They are having many, many exhibits all around England. But the stamps that I'm showing you there depict some of the well-known works of da Vinci, such as the skull section in 1489 and the head of Leda from 1505. So look around and you can see many other stamps over the years that Leonardo da Vinci has been honored. And the third anniversary kind of relates to something we did on this show a couple of months ago. That's there's a very famous singer, Nat King Cole. He was born in March of 1919, and there's some celebrations going on for his anniversary. And we want to give a shout out to some friends up in Toronto, Canada, at the Harry Sutherland Library, which is part of the Vincent Graves Green Philatelic Research Foundation. They contacted us here for some questions about some of the books we had, and we found out about them. Turns out our producer's brother, Andrew Sabbat, was only 15 minutes away, so he took a walk over there, found out that they do enjoy watching Going Postal, and we thank them for that, and said there's some big philatelic events coming up in Canada next month, and we'll give you more information about that. But we want to say hello to them and thank them for watching. Every show, we do a trivia contest. And last month's trivia contest, we had a couple of questions. One of them was, what was the first triangle stamp? And what was the largest stamp ever made by the United States Post Office? The answers were the first triangle stamp. You can see behind me, there were several of them celebrating an event. And the largest stamp was the Mars rover, called the Sojourner, which traveled to Mars, issued as a stamp, and then on even a bigger sheet, as you can see. It turns out it's named after Sojourner Truth, the famous abolitionist and writer about slavery, and it was actually suggested by a 12-year-old girl from Connecticut. They had an essay contest of what to name the rover. She wrote the essay, and she was selected. Get back to the other trivia one. It had to do with Chuck Yeager, the first pilot to break the sound barrier. There was a stamp issued. He's still alive, so he's not on a stamp yet. But the stamp honoring the anniversary of his breaking the sound barrier showed his plane, which was he named after his first wife, Glorious Glennis. And there's a little. The question was, what's the mistake on that stamp? Turns out they spelled his wife's name wrong. Very neat a magnifying glass to see it, but there was just a missing letter in her name. So this month's trivia question is related to artists, and we want to know what the philatelic connection is between all these artists, a man named William Powell, John Vanderlyn, Alfred Major, Randolph Rogers, Luigi Gregori, and Francisco Casanova. They all have a philatelic connection. We'll give you a little hint. It does have to do with a very famous commemorative series. So if you know those artists and why they're connected to stamps, send us in your answer to info@spellman.org, and we'll be announcing winners. The people who corrected last month's trivia, you see their names scrolling across the bottom of the screen. So that's some stamp news and anniversaries. We saw something interesting in the newspaper a while ago. It has to do with Fenway Park and Neil Diamond. Turns out Neil Diamond's song Sweet Caroline, which every member of Red Sox Nation knows all about, gets sung in the eighth inning of every home game. Turns out that song has been recognized for its cultural significance and has been selected as one of the 24 recordings inducted into the National Recording Registry. I mention it because Fenway Park came out on a stamp a number of years ago when the post office celebrated all those old-time baseball stadiums, which actually Fenway Park's the only one left, but it did appear on a stamp. We want to mention that hopefully you see this show before May 11th. We're having a special program at the museum to honor Sally Ride, the first American astronaut to go into space. She died in 2012 from cancer, unfortunately, but there is an actress named Cheryl Fay who does a great reenactment or impersonation of Sally Ride, and she'll be here at 10:30 on May 11th. It's a program good for kids and adults, and there's a nice connection. One of the reasons we're doing it, we call it Stamps Come Alive program, and that is that Sally Ride was a pretty much a lifelong stamp collector. She collected, of course, all space stamps. She was also a good tennis player, so she had some tennis stamps in her collection, and she also got some foreign stamps. Some of them were done after she passed away, and you can see those behind me. And she also obviously was enamored of the Russian first female cosmonaut, Valentina Tereshovas, I think. And she's on a Russian stamp which I believe was in Sally Ride's connection. So that's May 11th, 10:30, Saturday morning. And if you you can give us a call ahead of time to reserve a seat, although it's open attendance in that there. So, and now it's time for our special guest. He's with us every month. It's Archie, the stamp collecting alligator. Archie, come on up. Oh, look what Archie's got this month. He's got the Secretariat stamp on his hat. In fact, I think Archie's thinking of going down to Churchill Downs, have a little mint juleps, and enjoy the horse race there. So, yeah, this is a great hat, Archie. Why don't you take that down? Because Archie also got a present this month from one of his fans, and it turns out that Archie collects dentists on stamps. Let's see what you got, Arch. Oh, so what he got was a little alligator, and it's a little game, right? You know, you've been playing ever since you got it. And it, what you try to do is put all the teeth down before the alligator catches your finger. And it looks like I may be doing it correctly this round. Oh, look at that, Arch. I made it. Okay, well, here you go, Arch. Hold on to that, because we want to show you some dental stamps from Archie's collection. He has that 100th anniversary stamp that was done in 1959, celebrating the American Dental Association 100th anniversary. They made 120 million of those stamps. And then you see some stamps from Thailand, Korea, and Iceland. And we even found out by looking at an Austrian stamp that dentists have a patron saint. It's Saint Apollonia. And the stamp you see there is from Austria. Kind of interesting. Take a close look. And it looks like Saint Apollonia is holding a tooth that she must have extracted from somebody. So you got a good collection there, Arch. Okay, and we did learn that our students from India, Archie's collection last month was sharks, and they've started collecting sharks on stamps, so maybe they'll be looking for dentists too. Okay, Arch, take your gift down, and we'll see you next month. We also have our students from India who watch the show every month, and in fact, they told me that we'll be meeting Archie, and Archie collects sharks on stamps, and they saw him, and a number of Indian stamp collectors started doing sharks. But we always like to mention some philatelic connection to India, and that has to do with there were a number of sections of India before it became an official a nation, and there was a place called Hyderabad, I believe. I hope I'm pronouncing that correct. And they had their own set of stamps. It was like a principality inside India, and they were finally became part of India in 1948. But they make an interesting collection of stamps, and they had a big exhibit about those stamps. So Indian students, check out that collection for you. So, and let's see, already tell me our time is up. So let me just mention one other thing. We're going to be up at the Tewksbury Library on May 22nd for a program, and you can also bring your stamps in, and we'll take a look at them and give you a little idea of evaluations. And on our show, we always honor our presidents. May has two presidents born in May. On May 8th, 1884, Harry Truman was born. And our local president, President Kennedy, born on May 29th, 1917. And that's an interesting stamp because it was issued all over the country on the same day. And people collect. It's usually one stamp is issued only in a one city, and then the next day sold, but that one, because of the reaction of the country, they issued it all there. So that's, we've already kind of rushed through our show here. We've got a lot more. We'll be seeing you in June. Don't forget to email your answers to us.